everyone, welcome back to my channel. In this video, I'm going to talk about the process of oogenesis. The term oogenesis is derived from the Greek word in which oon means egg, genesis means origin. So oogenesis is a process of production of egg or the ovum. The process of oogenesis takes place in the female reproductive organ known as ovaries. Ovaries are the oval-shaped paired organ and it is present in the lower abdominal cavity near the pelvis region. And these ovaries are covered by an outermost layer known as germinal epithelium. These germinal epithelium consists of cells known as primordial germ cell. And it is this primordial germ cell which undergo process of oogenesis. The process of oogenesis mainly takes place in three phases, that is multiplication phase, growth phase and maturation phase. We'll discuss those process one by one. First step, that is multiplication phase. As the name indicate, in multiplication phase, the primordial germ cell undergo continuous mitotic division and it produces a cell known as oogonium. These oogonium are the stem cells. So they undergo mitotic division and produces oogonium. So this oogonium proliferate and it produces primary oocyte and ultimately it produces egg or the ovum. But the production of oogonium takes place during the early embryonic life itself. That is when the female fetus is present inside the body of the mother itself. So during the first month of the embryonic life, that is when the fetus is 1 month old inside the body of the mother, this primordial germ cell which is present in the ovary of the fetus, it will undergo mitotic division and it start to produce oogonium. So after the first month of the embryonic life, the production of oogonium begins and it continues. So by the end of the third month or when the fetus is 3 months old, some of this oogonia differentiate or proliferate and it produces primary follicle. Whereas the other oogonia, it undergo continuous mitotic division and it produces oogonia itself. So by the end of the 5th month, the ovary will be having 7 millions of oogonia. So out of these 7 millions, most of the oogonia undergo degeneration by the process known as atresia. And some of this oogonia will differentiate and produce as primary oocyte. So at the time of the birth, the female fetus will have 2 million of primary oocyte. So the production of primary oocyte always takes place before the birth itself. There is no production of primary oocyte after the birth. And out of this 2 million, only 4 lakh primary follicle will be present during the puberty. And out of this 4 lakh, hardly of about 450 primary follicle will mature and produce as egg. So in maturation phase, the oogonium undergo mitotic division and it produces primary oocyte. And the production of primary oocyte takes place before the birth itself. And this primary oocyte undergo meiotic division and is arrested in meiosis first until the female reaches puberty. Once the female reaches puberty, a day before ovulation, the meiosis first division will be completed. Now, this primary follicle undergoes second phase known as growth phase. During the growth phase, there will be increase in the size of this primary follicle due to accumulation of protein and fat to form a yolk. Due to heavy nature of the yolk, it accumulates in the lower portion of the primary oocyte to form a vegetative pole and the nucleus along with the cytoplasm occupies the upper region form an animal pole. So during the growth phase, the cytoplasm which is present in the animal pole become rich in DNA, RNA, enzymes, proteins, etc. And all the organelles start to accumulate in this cytoplasm. The nucleus which is present in the animal pole also increase in its size due to accumulation of nucleoplasm. And the nucleolus which is present inside the nucleus also increase in its size and the number of nucleolus also increases. Once these changes in the cytoplasm and the nucleus is completed, the primary oocyte is ready to undergo third phase known as maturation phase. During maturation phase, the primary oocyte complete meiosis first. Since the meiosis first is a reductional division, n number of chromosomes will be received by two daughter cells. After karyokinesis, there will be unequal cytokinesis. That is, large amount of cytoplasm is received by the one of the daughter cell and it is known as ooted or secondary oocyte. And very little amount of cytoplasm will be received by one more daughter cell and it is known as the first polar body. Now, the secondary oocyte and first polar body is ready to undergo second meiotic division. Even in the second meiotic division, unequal cytokinesis takes place. So, the secondary oocyte gives rise to one large ripe egg which receives large amount of cytoplasm and it gives rise to second polar body which receives very little amount of cytoplasm. Even the first polar body undergo second meiotic division and it produces two more polar body. So all this polar body or the polar site which is produced as a result of oogenesis, it will degenerate. And now this ripe egg or the ovum is ready for the ovulation. And the egg is ready for the fertilization. So that is how the process of oogenesis takes place. I hope you like this video. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.